name's Mark. I'm the tunnel manager here at Long Itchington Wood. Today, we've just witnessed the incredible breakthrough of Dorothy completing the second one-mile tunnel. It's been an incredible journey, a difficult journey, made possible by the team effort of 400 people, of staff, the workforce, and the engineers. So now we'll have a look at the work that's gone on behind the scenes to get us to this point.
Today we are at Long Itchington Wood at the North Portal, and we'll be giving a look to Dorothy for the preparation of the second breakthrough, popping a bit around the site, explaining what's going to be happening in the future. Let's go! So we're now at the segment yard. We're using several types of vehicles. One is for the personnel, which we're going to onboard in a few minutes, getting ready to move to the TBM. The other types of vehicle we are using are the MSVs, the multi-service vehicles, where we're going to load segments and grout, supplying the TBM for the logistics. We're now at our teleyard that is controlling all the access to the tunnel. Paul is our teleman for the day, and he's going to log our entry and deliver for us the safe set for self-rescuing. We got our gears and we're now moving to the TBM, which is about to break through. Our second tunnel was much faster than the first one, so we had a lot of lessons learned from the previous drive, that most of the workers stay with us all the duration of the turnaround and are now delivering with us the second tunnel. All the learning of the crews was a very good asset for us on the delivery of the second tunnel and helped us to build up a much better performance on this second drive. I'm happy to be in the cabin and being with the crews, being able to adjust and see what's going on with the TBM, because that's remained to be my main focus. I mean, getting closer and closer to the breakthrough. I'm very happy. I'm very happy that the second drive went much better.
So we're at Long Itchington. We're here for the second breakthrough. I feel privileged to be here today as well, because I was here for the actual launch of this Dorothy. So yeah, I feel great to be here.
You don't see many tunnel breakthroughs in construction and in the rider world. So it's really exciting to be here today, witness it happen, and watch it with my team.
Today is an immensely proud moment for me. I mean, it's a culmination of 3 years' work.
It's very exciting. It's a big milestone, finishing the second tunnel and preparation for the future works.
So when a machine is going to break through and while passing the diaphragm wall, the diaphragm concrete wall, we'll be watching at different parameters. Mainly a lot of attention to focus on our slurry that is taking all the spoils and all the cuts from the front to our slurry treatment plant in surface. But as well, we're going to control all the hydraulic pressures on the different cylinders we're having, trying to control and make the breakthrough in a very controlled manner, ensuring that all the head is in full in contact, the steering of the machine is correct, so we are targeting straight in the middle where we should be. So how do we control the steering of the machine is a combination of different things. The first one is our TBM pilots that are controlling the hydraulic pressure on different cylinders that are pushing the machine and driving in different directions. So every advance, because of we're building the tunnel, and the ring is setting the direction of the tunnel. On that, the computer or the software is recalculating and anticipating what will be the next advance after 2 meters. So the guys, they are adjusting the pressure here, trying to match the red cross to be straight into the middle. Here we are, straight at the front of our TBM, currently building a ring, and the people are getting around, quite experienced now, with numerous rings being built. So they're just moving the 8-ton segments behind me. They will set it into position. The process is now being fully controlled by the team. It's a very specific process, engaging a lot of safety aspects and requiring a high level of concentration for the crews. But now they are a bit of mastering their stuff and being able to build rings in less than 20 minutes. We're going to leave our crews finishing the tunnel. The next time you're going to see this machine will be on the breakthrough from the south portal, where there will be the cutterhead visible for the whole public.
It's an incredibly proud achievement to reach this point. So this tunnel has taken 4 months. We learnt a lot of lessons from the first drive, and that's resulted in improved performance. We're now looking forward to the challenge of taking the machine apart and sending it to Bromford for its onward journey.
Ah, absolutely amazed. It's fantastic to be there. Again, a very long journey and a good challenge. So happy really for the team.
It's definitely a moment I'll remember forever in my career.
So it's great to see it come out the other end. It's been a journey, seeing it go all the way through, work on it while it's been in the tunnel. Couldn't ask for anything better.